Welcome back to Family Health Today. For many, acid reflux is a chronic condition that results in frequent painful heartburn and many sleepless nights. Now, a new incisionless procedure gives patients the chance to find long-term relief from the pain and irritation caused by this condition. Joining us now to discuss this condition and its new form of treatment is Dr. Jeffrey Keller, one of the first and only surgeons in Northwest Arkansas to perform this procedure. Welcome, Dr. Keller.
Well, thank you.
Thanks for being here with us today.
Well, thank you for having me.
First, tell us, what is GERD?
GERD is an acronym for gastroesophageal reflux disease, which is essentially acid or fluids in the stomach reflux into the esophagus. That can cause minor symptoms such as heartburn or even advanced symptoms including asthma and other upper GI and respiratory problems.
Approximately how many people suffer from this condition?
The numbers vary anywhere from 25 to 60 million. Probably the solid number is about 25 million, so about 7% of the American population is treated for gastric reflux, either prescription or over-the-counter medications.
Now, is this condition more common in men or women?
It's probably equally distributed.
What about age? Does that play a role in this condition?
As we approach middle age, the incident increases. However, we see it in patients as young as in their early 20s.
And what exactly causes this, Dr. Keller? I mean, can you be born with it? I know we see it in young babies, but then sometimes people don't seem to have it until later in life.
Absolutely. We do see it in some children, especially those with developmental delays. That's a different process. Mm-hmm. That's more of a neurological issue of the stomach and the way it functions. This is more of an acquired disease. Mm-hmm. It sometimes can be related to a hiatal hernia, which is where the stomach and the esophagus ascend into the chest cavity. Some of it is related to weight gain. It can also be related to diet. We see a lot more of it in Western Europe and America than we do in Asia and other parts of the world, but it is becoming more prevalent there.
So, for example, a person who is obese may develop GERD.
Certainly.
But if they lose weight, will that condition improve?
It sometimes can. Fat deposition within the abdomen can change the anatomy at the esophageal junction with the stomach, and that can change the direction of the valve. Most GERD is related to just the flattening of that gastroesophageal valve, though.
I see. What are some of the basic non-invasive ways to treat this condition?
Well, the most common that people will use, most likely the first line, would be something like Tums or Mylanta. People experience heartburn and they'll take an over-the-counter medication such as that. The next level of intervention would be Pepcid, the classic histamine antagonist and blockers. The last 15 years we've seen the introduction, or last actually 10 years introduction of Nexium and Prevacid and Protonix, the proton pump inhibitor class. And those were introduced for the express purpose of treating the esophagitis, the erosive esophagitis that develops from reflux disease.
And it's important to treat this condition not only for pain relief, but I understand it can actually lead to cancer. Is that correct?
That is correct. In certain situations, it can lead to cancer. Now, not everybody who has GERD is going to get cancer, just like everybody who has a colon polyp is not going to get colon cancer. However, it is an indicator of chronic irritation. And the lining of the esophagus, just very similar to skin that is chronically irritated, can revert or change into a early cancerous type of process.
Are there some lifestyle habits or changes that can help prevent GERD? I know you mentioned diet earlier, but what else? I know maybe some basic tips like not wearing tight clothing, that sort of thing.
That certainly can. People who have decreased gut motility will have increased gastric pressures and they'll have reflux. So that's a physiological thing. And that can be mechanical from tight clothes, things like that. We see a lot of reflux in with carbonated beverages, anything that performs gas in the stomach. The more acidic foods will obviously cause more acid in the stomach to bounce back and forth.
I see. Now, I understand there's a new procedure called TIF, and you are one of the first and only surgeons in our area to perform this new technique. Tell us, what is this technique, and what does TIF stand for?
Well, first, what TIF stands for is transoral incisionless fund application. It's the device that is, there's been, the history of this is for the last 5 or 6 years, people have been trying to figure out a way to treat GERD without having to have incisions. The classic treatment for it is what's called a fundoplication, where the stomach is wrapped around the esophagus to reform the valve that has flattened out. We originally did that open. 15, 20 years ago, we converted over to laparoscopy, and that has pretty much been the gold standard. In the last 3 years, this incisionless process has become more prevalent and is actually becoming mainstream now. What essentially this does is recreates the internal valve just as we had with the open surgery. So it's fundamentally the same surgery that we were performing.
Sure. Can you kind of just briefly take us through the steps of what exactly goes on through this procedure?
Absolutely. Under general anesthetic, we introduce a device that's made by endogastric solution. It's a specially made device that fits over an endoscope, so an EGD scope. That goes into the esophagus and into the stomach. Once we're in the stomach, the scope and the distal tip of the device are disengaged, and the scope is turned upside down to watch the procedure. At that point, the device has a hinge on it, an elbow, and that folds back, and there's a retracting device that allows us to grab the portion of the stomach that has gone into the abdomen, or out of the abdomen into the chest cavity, and pull it down. At that point, we'll then place some specially designed, engineered fasteners that hold the stomach in place and recreate the valve. It's on the corners is about 2 centimeters, and in the middle, it's anywhere from 3 to 4 centimeters is the valve length that we're looking. And that creates a tube, the esophagus, with a flap valve on the end. So when you swallow, the valve opens. When you, when it's working, the stomach's working, the valve closes shut and acid doesn't come back
up
to the esophagus.
Very neat. So. Now, is this a one-time event or will it need to be repeated, say, in 15, 20 years?
The majority of people from our Nissen experience have immediate relief of their symptoms and long-term resolution of their symptoms. We expect that this will be the same. The fund application has been shown for approximately 5 years now in Europe and 3 years here in the States to be holding people symptom-free for approximately 80% of the people will be symptom-free and be off medications.
Fantastic. Now, who is a candidate for this procedure and who is not a candidate, Dr. Keller?
Well, candidate, someone who could be considered for it would be anybody with reflux that is not controlled with their medications or they forget their medications or have no desire to take their medications every day. You know, that would be someone young who's very active and forgets, and by the end of the day they have heartburn. People, as I mentioned, who don't control their symptoms with their medications and they're continually having to up the amount of medicine they take to control the medicines are ideal candidates. People who are not candidates are anybody with a hiatal hernia greater than 2 centimeters. And in the workup, we will do studies and endoscopy to determine the size of the hiatal hernia. However, those people are perfect candidates for a laparoscopic procedure, which is takes a little bit longer to recover from, but has been the gold standard in the past. People that are definitely not candidates at this point, people with the morbidly obese with a BMI of over 35, because of the mechanics of the device, it makes it difficult to grasp the tissue. So.
I see. For this, for more information, where can our viewers go to get maybe some contact information to learn more about this procedure and your services?
Certainly. They can contact our office, Ozark Surgical Associates, at 521-1484. We also have a website, www.ozarksurgicalassociates.com. Or we can also be reached through a link at Washington Regional by either searching for myself or our clinic.
So, absolutely. Fantastic.
Through their website.
Very good. Any final words of wisdom for our viewers, Dr. Keller?
Well, I think the biggest point that a lot of people don't realize about GERD is that it's a mechanical problem and it deserves a mechanical fix. A good number of the people that have GERD and are treated with medicines do just fine. But for people who do not are not happy with their control, with their reflux, this is certainly the solution for it.
Very good. Well, thank you so much for being here today, and we appreciate your service in our community.
Well, thank you very much for having me. It's
All
been a
right.
wonderful time.
Stay tuned. Family Health Today. We'll be right back.